Fikile Mbalula uthi only Jacob Zuma defeated the ANC. No one else should claim any credit after that because it is only this man that defeated the ANC. And by the way, he also goes as far as saying, by the way, Jacob Zuma is from the ANC. You understand? In other words, it took somebody within the ANC to defeat the ANC. Quite interesting. So we will talk about that shortly, provided that you are interested. If you are, then you definitely need to stick around. So wait. In an article released by the citizen.co.za, this is what they say. Zuma defeated the ANC. Mbalula. Fikile Mbalula says Zuma was the reason for the ANC lost. Even though I did not get enough notes to rule alone, ANC Secretary General Fikile Mbalula says the only person who defeated the party in this year's election was Jacob Zuma. I vum in dug. Oh, surely silo sat bayoze bati puti. What's your take? Bayoze bati puti. Usho silo. Na kuge manju figile mbalulu tai. It is only Zuma that defeated the ANC. So in other words, if you bring back the vote against Zuma to the ANC, probably people wouldn't, in fact, majority of people, in other words, would have voted for ANC. That's what I'm hearing. I don't know if you disagree with that. Do you agree or you disagree? You're going to have to tell me in the comment section below, right? So we'll go through this. And yeah, I think I saw that video where Fikile Mbalula was talking about that. But. There's this that I think we need to talk about. This. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, so let's proceed. Mbalula was speaking in an interview broadcast live on X, right? The ANC got 40% in the last election, making a way for multi-party governance system in South Africa for the first time since 1994. According to Mbalula, the formation of MK Party was responsible for the ANC's dismal loss in May general election. Now, if I proceed, do you agree or you disagree that it was the formation of the MK Party that gave them a hard time? That gave them... So if it was the formation of the MK Party, why wouldn't they work with MK Party? Because, I mean, you still have AMA elections that are coming. So why wouldn't they work with EMK party in general? Because, I mean, my local elections in 2026, guys, is just around the corner. So you still need EMK party. But let's proceed. He then say,
he says that the EFF, DA, and all small parties combined did not defeat the ANC. Jacob Zuma did by coming out of the ranks of the ANC, says Mbalula. So in other words, here what I'm hearing is that the only way he succeeded in doing it is also because he's coming out of the ranks of the ANC, guys. Officially, again, one will argue and say, is that are you trying to tell me that the only person that could defeat it, look, comes from the rank of the ANC, then what about the leader, UTM,
Was he not part and parcel of the ANC? What about the leader of the EFF? Was not part and parcel of the ANC? You know what I'm saying? So the taking credit of he comes from us really doesn't make sense to me, right? Despite being launched in December last year, Zuma's MK party was the official opposition, was the official opposition party parliament and was the third largest party in the country after DA. Is, guys, the article is written incorrectly, it's a matter of English. Not was, is means present. In the present moment, they are the official opposition party. That biggest part in the present moment. So is. I'm very curious, you know, I'm very concerned when this journalist are writing things these days, because they might say things where you think you take it lightly and yeah, they are intentional. You know what I'm saying? They are intentionally damaging you know what I'm saying? So I need to correct things on time. But let's proceed. One of the MK party's demands for the coalition was that President Ramaphosa must be removed as the ANC leader and for the ANC-MK coalition to work. The coalition will also include EFF, right? Utike, it is the ANC that will kill itself. Zuma once done, look, Zuma has done that in 2024. Hey, yeah, perfect. It is the ANC that will kill itself. So which one do you take then? Did the ANC kill itself? Maybe they are right when they say the ANC will kill itself. Because that might be a figurative speech to say they will kill themselves through their arrogancy. Because also it's the very same reason why people wouldn't want to vote with the ANC. It was only... the major problem was it had to do with the arrogancy. So maybe when you look, or as you look at the word, it will kill itself. It's not necessarily that. Maybe how best can I explain this? But yeah, it's just along the lines to say, it will kill itself. Maybe in a sense of arrogancy. Of which again, speaking about arrogancy. It has been in abundance when it comes to the ANC. And in fact, they even gone to an extent where they do acknowledge the leaders. I'll start by KZN. In KZN, a lot of leaders in KZN did acknowledge that what killed the ANC is arrogance, right? They did acknowledge that. Moving right along, you know what happened in KZN here? Shame. Now they are in power through backdoors. So we all know that. And I don't need to explain that to you. Also, nationally, the ANC did acknowledge that the reason they are where they are today, it is simply because of their arrogance. So what do you say? What's your take about it? Like, I'm interested. I want to know what's your take about the fact that they are where they are simply because they've been destroyed by their very own arrogancy. Now, the key word there is arrogancy. So in other words, they are trying to say, do not give credit to Zuma, credit that is not due to him. And in other words, the only reason why we died, or the only reason why we are out of power, it is because of our arrogancy, which... At the very same time, I kind of feel like, oh, okay, so if that's the case, then it's fine. So at the end of it all, you are defeated. And that's what you should note here, is that at the end of it all, you are defeated. You are not in power. You are not in power because of what? Arrogance. Whether Zuma did a magic or no magic, the bottom line is that you are declining. Get into the comment section below. In the comment section below, I'll be on the lookout of your comments. I'm interested to know and to hear what you've got to say. Only Zuma. It's not the EFF. It's not the DA. It's not all the small political parties in South Africa that put the ANC to the position where it is, but it's only because of Zuma. Get into the comment section below. Tell me what you think about that statement.